I am Dr. S. K. Sharma, endocrinologist working at Jaipur. Today we are going to discuss the role of oral antidiabetic drugs in gestational diabetes. Whenever we treat our gestational diabetes, the one classical statement is that after lifestyle measures fails, patient should be on insulin therapy. But there are many studies which highlighted that intensive insulin therapy reduces perinatal outcome. Now, once we say that insulin is not crossing placenta, then we think that it is safe. But if you want to give oral drugs, why you want to give oral drugs? Because people are afraid of insulin, it is cumbersome, adherence to insulin is poor, and there are more chances of hypoglycemia and weight gain with insulin therapy. So, there is any problem? May I continue? So, if you want to give oral drugs, there are two concepts. Use drugs which are not crossing placenta and not causing any harmful effect to the fetus and neonate, or use drug which do cross placenta, but we have evidence that they do not cause harm, they do not increase perinatal mortality and morbidity, and they do not have any teratogenic effect during gestational diabetes. So in that background, if we say metformin, it crosses placenta, but it is considered to be safe, no hypoglycemia, no teratogenic effect, and it also released in breast milk in very small amount, so we allow patient to continue with metformin during breastfeeding. But there are many studies with metformin with pros and cons. Now, there was a landmark study by the name of MIG, that is metformin in gestational diabetes, where large number of patients were compared, divided into two groups by insulin group and metformin group. The problem with metformin group was that 48% of these patients required insulin supplementation because they were not achieving good control with metformin. But the perinatal outcome were more or less similar to that seen with insulin arm. So people are now arguing that can we give metformin in our GDM patients? Recently, there are more data available by small studies where some minor, you can say, defects were highlighted. Particularly, there is increase in preterm delivery when patients were on metformin. The other drug is glibenclamide, also called gliburide in USA. This is a drug which is crossing least to the placenta and going to the fetus because of its very high binding to the protein in the mother. So this drug is effective. In one of the trial by Langer et al., large number of patients were divided into two groups, insulin and glibenclamide, and they followed this patient and identified that the overall risk of perinatal morbidity and mortality is same. Only 4% of the patient were not able to achieve good control with glibenclamide and they were shifted to insulin. Otherwise, in that study, glibenclamide was shown to be effective as insulin. But later on, more and more studies were done with glibenclamide and they highlighted that there is some increased risk of macrosomia, fetal and neonatal hypoglycemia during treatment with glibenclamide. So now still the debate is on. People are arguing whether to give these oral drugs or not. Other oral antidiabetic drugs are not recommended, like meglitinide group of drugs like repaglinide and natiglinide have no experience. In small studies with acarbose, people have identified that it is having equal efficiency as compared to metformin, but there is an argument that this unabsorbed carbohydrate going to colon converted into butyrate and causing some increase in prostaglandin. That is a fear, but it is a theoretical fear. So we are hoping that in near future, more studies will be there with acarbose in GDM patients. So now recommendations, if you look into different guidelines, are that ADA and American College of obstetricians and gynecologists say that insulin is the preferred treatment, but if the patients are not able to take insulin or patient refuses insulin, then you can give metformin. Other recommendations like NICE guidelines and Canadian guidelines highlight that you can give these oral drugs if the patients are not taking insulin. So they have some positive influence on these NICE guidelines and Canadian guidelines as compared to ADA guidelines. The endocrine guidelines are very old, 1913, and they say that glibenclamide, they prefer glibenclamide over metformin as a oral anti-diabetic drug during gestational diabetes. But of course, at present, insulin is still at the, you can say, lead when you are treating your gestational diabetic patient for controlling hyperglycemia. Thank you.